Hey guys, welcome to another edition of Rotter Tube Brief, new show every Saturday. Please like and subscribe to the channel so you're sent an email every time a new video comes out, which is every Saturday. Those of you who don't know, nitrates are bad. When your fish eats, just like us, it goes pee and it goes number two. This pee is ammonia, as all urine is. And since your aquarium is nothing more than a glorified toilet with pee and uneaten food rotting and number two all over your tank, the more fish, the more waste. Beneficial bacteria in your water. You might think, bacteria, that's bad. Well, in your fish tank, it's really good. That bacteria is going to break down the ammonia into nitrites, which is less harmful to fish. Nitrites are then broken down into nitrates, like I said. Nitrates are really bad for your corals and your inverts, especially coral. Your fish can tolerate nitrates up to around 40 to 60, but your nitrates need to be kept around zero. There's a lot of test kits on the market. I prefer the API brand. My nitrates were higher in my aquarium, as some of you may remember from previous videos, because I have a high bio load, which means a lot of fish. So there's a lot of fish urine being broken down into nitrates, and the nitrates are either removed from your aquarium by doing water changes or having a really good protein skimmer that skims out the nutrients, gets them out of your tank. Well, that's not enough sometimes. There's a couple other things you can do. You can have a refugium in your sump, which I've never done because it's just extra work. That's just me. Keep in mind, when I say extra work for me, that's me. It might be different for you guys. You might want the refugium. You might want to trim down plants. You might want to get rid of that Cheeto or Chiato or Cheez-Its or Cheetos or whatever you guys want to call it. So me personally, I want to have the best filtration with the least amount of work. That's the key, right? That's what we all want. So you have your biological filtration, which is your bacteria. The more bacteria you have in your aquarium, the better, because it's going to break down all that bad stuff. I added a couple more fish, and then my nitrates were about 20 or 30. The water in here will turn a certain color. Hold it up against it. Whatever the color is, that's how many nitrates you have. I've got 5 milliliters of water. I figured I would just test here with you guys. Turn it upside down there a few times just to make sure the solution is in the water all even. You need to shake this for 30 seconds.
That's what she said.
All right, now that that's all shaken up, you're gonna open this guy. And you're going to put 10 drops. Now we are going to let it sit for 5 minutes and then check what the color is. I'm going to keep it up against the white and hold it up against the bright light, maybe the outside. Yeah, I don't really like that. What does it look like to you guys? It looks like 40, that's not cool. There's too many nitrates in that water. Anything above the yellow, the bright yellow, is too much. Not good for the coral. The fish don't appreciate it either, but they can tolerate it. So, what I'm gonna do is put this marine pure block in. After like a month and a half, I'll let you guys know what happens, but I'll tell you what, the last time I had the marine pure block in, after about 5 or 6 weeks, I had zero nitrates. It's an 8 inch by 8 inch by 4 inch block. Now check this out. The surface area, which is not just outside the block, but inside, the surface area is 23,000 square feet. You know how much beneficial bacteria can live on that? A lot. So I'm just gonna take the biopellet reactor out for now, and less electricity to use, every little bit helps, right? The other marine pure block, which is in my quarantine tank, can never be used in my main tank, which is why I had to buy a separate one. Why, you ask? Because I dosed some copper solution, liquid copper, in the tank to kill any ick parasite or marine velvet that may be in my quarantine tank. That also has copper in it now. The block does. The copper will kill your inverts in your coral, so it can never go in the tank. If I put that block in my display tank, it would nuke my display tank and my corals and inverts, shrimp, snails would die.
Thanks for watching!